Emotional eating, sexuality, and money. Why people eat more than they need. Hi guys, my name is Elena Semenek and this is my YouTube channel Psychology of Happiness. Welcome! If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing and checking my other videos because here I share with you my professional experience, my personal experience about money, love, relationship, sexuality, health. Here I do free self-development webinars and post self-motivational educational videos about psychology and help you to become happier and more successful in life. Today we're gonna talk about emotional eating, sexuality, and money. This webinar is the fifth webinar that I prepared for you about emotional eating. This webinar is free and this webinar is dedicated for the online course, 12-week online course, Weight Loss Vaccine. There are total, as I said, 5 free webinars. All of them are dedicated to a specific topic, to our emotions, to our food addictions, to passive and aggressive dependency. We also spoke about how eating addiction is developed. All the links are below in the description of this video. And all those webinars are free. So today we're gonna talk about sexuality and money and how those two things are related to food. Most psychologists agree that out of all topics, there are two which are the most sensitive to discuss: sex and money. We will start with sex. Sex is what we do, sexuality is what we are. Let's look at sexuality on a broad spectrum, not as an act of intimacy, but as a self-identifying factor. Your sexuality includes the following. 1. Your physical appearance and your gender attractiveness, such as body shapes and femininity for women and muscles and masculinity for men. Number 2. How comfortable you feel in your body. Do you accept your body? Are you often criticize your body? 3. How attractive you feel with your partner. How attractive you feel in your romantic relationship, when you flirt or when you go out with your partner. Number 4. How easy it is for you to receive pleasure in life. Not just sexual pleasure, but pleasure in general. The ability to experience pleasure, joy, and happiness. Number 5. Do you feel comfortable when you give pleasure to another person? And number 6. How much do you like your self-reflection in the mirror? As you already learned from my previous webinars, people with overweight problems often feel unworthy and often experience low self-esteem. It is particularly true when it comes to their physical body. Although some people might present themselves sexy and confident, in reality, this is just another defense mechanism to hide their vulnerable little boy or little girl inside. If we are being honest with ourselves, then we can see that sexuality always reflects our self-perception. Extra weight often helps us to hide our insecurity in romantic relationships. You might disagree with me and say that some people look very sexy and are not afraid to show their body even if they are overweight. This is true for some people, but not for the majority. Even some of those sexy mamas in reality are pretending that everything is fine. They are pretending that everything is okay. They are playing the role of a sexy, confident person, but actually they are protecting a little child inside of them. Their inner child is hurt and scared. Extra weight is a common defense mechanism to hide emotional pain and insecurity. Let's talk about how we use extra weight in our lives. Number 1. Extra weight helps people to hide their sexuality. We are hiding our beautiful body shapes and curves behind the extra weight. Number 2. Big people wear big clothes. Hoodies, white pants, and oversized sweaters are adding extra layers to protect their vulnerable body. Number three, women with extra weight don't wear heels. And heels, as you know, are sexy. Number four, women with extra weight don't show their body on the beach and don't wear sexy swimsuits. They usually don't swim at all. They hide their body from the public. Number five, men with extra weight can show off their muscles and they can play volleyball on the beach. They usually take their drink and hang out in the pool area. Number six, women with extra weight sleep in big pajamas and almost never wear a sexy nightgown. Women who did not receive acknowledgement of their beauty from parents, especially from their fathers, are afraid to be beautiful. They don't know how to react when they see that a man desires them sexually. They are afraid to be sexy. They don't know how to accept compliments and how to be hot and feminine. Men with extra weight often feel that they are not worthy of dating beautiful women. Such men might be sexually attracted to a feminine woman, but often they doubt that a woman like that would fall for them. Most men won't even try because they don't want to be rejected. Let's do a small test. From 1 to 0, where the 10 is the maximum, how much do you love and accept your own body? This includes how much you take care of your body, doing exercises, beauty services, massages. How do you feel when you spend money on yourself, not on your loved ones, but on yourself? Do you accept your own body during intimacy? Are you allowing yourself to make noises and facial expression during sex? Are you okay with body odors? Don't try to overthink this. It is a simple self-diagnostic test. You don't have to do anything with this number. You don't have to share this number. This is just for you to reflect on it. Let's talk about how food and sexuality is connected. Food and sexuality share a common element, pleasure. Food and sexuality are all about physical and psychological pleasure. Pleasure in general is the ability to receive joy, fun, and happiness. It is an ability to relax and let go of control. This is not as simple as it sounds, of course not. We live in a world where we have lots of tension, lots of stress, discomfort, and anxiety. Our daily routine can be overwhelming. We live in fear. The world is developing quickly with rapid advances in technology, modern science, and social media. All those things make it harder and harder for us to predict our future. We live in fear. We fear the unknown. Pleasure is occupying less and less space in our life. By the time we are in bed, we are exhausted. As you've learned from my previous webinars, and if you haven't seen them, please check them out. All the links are below in the video description. So as you've learned from my previous webinars, food helps us to deal with stress, helps us to relax, and of course helps us to receive pleasure. When we eat, we feel good, quick and easy. Often people don't even notice this defense mechanism. Often people use food to compensate the lack of love, sexuality, pleasure in their life, and they do it subconsciously. They don't even realize it. Let's talk about how a lack of sexuality and pleasure in life can affect us in a negative way. Again, here we will talk not about the physical sexual act, which is of course a natural way to receive pleasure, but in this specific webinar, we will talk about sexuality itself as an energy. It is our ability to connect with our body and our feelings and the way to express ourselves. So number one, when we do not allow ourselves to express our sexuality, we often cannot be creative and cannot connect to our talents. Creativity and sexuality are just different presentations of the same energy. Poets write their stories, artists create their masterpieces, songwriters can touch millions of hearts when they connect with the creative side of their sexuality. Number two, sexuality reflects our relationships with money. Money and sexuality are two sides of the same coin. Sexuality brings self-confidence. Self-confidence brings money. People with low self-esteem cannot ask for promotion at work, and they are afraid to speak up for themselves. On the other hand, when we have money, it's much easier to be sexy. Are you agree? It's much easier to express yourself when you have money. Money gives us freedom. Therefore, sexuality and money carry the same energy. Ability to express ourselves, ability to experience pleasure, fun, and happiness in our life. If you work on your sexuality, then more money will come to your life. You might say that there are many successful people who are overweight, and this is true. But just imagine how much potential they still have. Once they work on their psychological reasons for overeating, they can unlock their full potential. Number three, lack of sexuality does not allow us to experience our life fully. Sexuality is our vital energy, the energy of life. Literally speaking, in order to have a baby, we need sex. In order to create a life, we need sex. There are a lot of taboos regarding sexuality. Parents don't know how to talk about it with their children. Women often feel ashamed to discuss their sex life with each other. Men often avoid this topic and choose to talk about politics, sports, stocks, bonds, and cars instead. Sexuality is 100% related to our physical body and how we express ourselves. We are blocking our emotions and our feelings. Often, we don't understand our own desires and we don't know what we want in life. As a result, we cannot experience our life fully. We are prohibiting pleasure in our life. We often forget how important is it to take care of ourselves and to take care of our body. We are afraid to be selfish and often sacrifice ourselves for others. Number four, women are hiding their sexuality because they don't trust men. Extra weight helps us to avoid relationships. Women are afraid to be hurt. Although consciously they want to find their Mr. Right, subconsciously, they avoid it because they are afraid of men. They are afraid to be attractive and sexy because they cannot trust men. Number five, same with men. They are hiding their sexuality because men don't trust women. If a man was raised by an emotionally unavailable mother, he cannot trust women. He can take on the role of a player and date many women instead. This way, he can avoid commitment. This way, he is in charge. He is the one who initiates a breakup or just simply disappears from a woman's life. It's not because he is a bad guy, but mostly because he cannot trust women. He cannot create a healthy, loving relationship. He is afraid of commitment. He is avoiding it. People often don't allow themselves to connect to their true feelings. They don't allow themselves to fall in love because they are afraid to be vulnerable. They are afraid that another person will break their heart. In order for a person to hide his sexuality, they have to suppress their true feelings and emotions. One of the easiest ways to do it is with food. Food helps us to refocus our brain. Food has different flavors, textures, and temperature. Therefore, we can experience a wide variety of sensations when we eat. We all know that food brings emotional and physical pleasure. This is the perfect substitute for sexuality. What influences the formation of our sexuality? The answer lies with our parents, of course, in our childhood. The way they express their sexuality, the words they use towards each other, the words and reactions they use toward you, the comments they made about your body, about your clothes, about your appearance, the amount of hugs, kisses, and affection you had in your family. The same-sex parent teaches a child how to treat themselves and accept their own body. The opposite-sex parent gives a child a confirmation on his sexuality. For example, when a mother says proud words to her son, when she compliments his intelligence, his bravery, she is confirming his masculinity. When a father says to his daughter that she is beautiful, she is his princess, he is confirming her charm and her femininity. By observing the way our parents treat each other, we receive a confirmation or criticism regarding our femininity or masculinity. We pick up on words they use behind each other's backs and how they address each other every day. I have a separate webinar entitled Four Types of Women, Father-Daughter Relationships. I will add the link in the video description. In that webinar, I talk in details about four important stages of forming female sexuality and role of the father in that process. Please check the link below the video and watch that webinar. What our body shape can tell us about our sexuality? Sexuality is a type of pleasure that forms in early childhood. If you watched my previous webinar, then you know that the first pleasure that a child receives is during breastfeeding. The pleasure that we receive with milk and with physical contact with mother's body is the foundation of our sexuality. Of course, there are a lot of other factors that will affect our sexuality later in life. But the initial ability to feel pleasure and to connect with other people is formed from the moment a baby feels mother's milk in his mouth. From the moment when mother is holding a baby. The connection between food and pleasure is so strong that if we don't receive enough pleasure in life, we compensate it with food. Talented people can receive pleasure from creating poems, songs, and paintings. But the majority of us, people like you and me, we go for a simple solution, which is food. Today, I would like to share with you the theory about how our body shape can tell us about our psychological problems. This theory was developed a few years ago in Russia in one of the medical institutes that studies in depth the psychology of extra weight. You've probably heard about five standard figure types: rectangular, triangle, hourglass, pear, and apple. This research was done mostly on women because those five types refer to women figures. An apple figure type. The extra weight is mostly concentrated in the center of the body, from chest to hips. Their neck, face, arms, and legs are usually skinny. Psychologically, these women are very strong and controlling. These women can build a very successful career. Usually, they don't fit in the role of a housewife. These women share a lot of masculine traits, such as leadership, bravery, persistence. These women are usually goal-oriented and like to compete with men. Their psychological traumas can be traced to the relationship with their fathers. A pear figure type. An extra weight is mostly concentrated in the lower part of their body, lower belly and hips. These women have had relationship problems with their mothers or female caregivers. These women often don't trust men. The extra weight in the lower body subconsciously is working as a shield to protect their private parts. They are great mothers, but when it comes to sexuality, they feel insecurity and self-doubts. Hourglass and rectangular figures. When they gain weight, their weight is distributed among the whole of their body. These women have psychological traumas from their relationships between their mother and father. In childhood, these women were playing the role of mediator between their parents. Often, these women were playing the role of a hero trying to reconcile their mother and father and smooth over family conflicts. Please let me know in the comments what type of figure you have and if you are able to relate to this theory. Please ask your questions, write your comments in the comment section below of this video. In psychology, we choose exercises and methods based on the problem that we are working on. If you go to the gym and you want to lose extra weight in your belly, then your trainer chooses the specific exercises for that purpose. Same in psychology. When you tell your therapist a problem, the therapist, the psychologist, will pick the best method and the best technique to help you to heal from this problem. Therefore, it is extremely important to identify correctly the main reason for your extra weight. Usually, there is not just one reason. Often, there are at least four or five reasons that work as a defense mechanism, as a complex, to deal with your psychological wounds. Extra weight is a type of security that you're using subconsciously to avoid dealing with your actual trauma. Your wound is asking to be healed, but it keeps getting ignored. Therefore, you have to eat more and more to suppress your wound, to suppress your pain. If you don't address your hidden pain, then it could grow and you could develop obesity or other irreversible medical problems like diabetes, heart diseases, etc. Let's summarize. Extra weight is a psychological shield that we use to hide our sexuality. It helps us to hide our vulnerable body. Sexuality is the ability to give and receive pleasure. Sexuality is the ability to trust our partner and express ourselves freely. When we feel insecure, when our self-confidence is low, or when we cannot create healthy boundaries, we use extra weight to hide our sexuality and to suppress our true feelings and emotions. I created five free self-development webinars about psychology of emotional eating. I encourage you to watch all five of them. The number one is entitled Food as a Substitute for Love. Number two, Food and Emotions. Tell me what you eat and I will tell you what problems you have. Number three, Oral Personality Type and Food Dependency. Number four, Food as a Universal Remedy for Better and for Worse. And number six is today's webinar, Food, Sexuality and Money. If you haven't seen any of those webinars, or if you saw only maybe short part of one of them, please check out the links in the description of this video and you can watch all five webinars for free here on YouTube. I also would like to invite you to my 12-week healing online course, Weight Loss Vaccine. You can try 1,000 diets, but if you don't address your psychological reasons for overeating, diets and exercise won't work. People gain even more weight after dieting. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me. You can send your questions in the comment section of this video, or you can submit them on my website. You can also send me a message on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. All the links are in the video description. I am sure you have your stories to share. I am sure you have your concerns. Please don't hesitate to share and to write about your thoughts, your questions, and your problems. I am here to help you to become happier, healthier, and more successful in life. Please give me a thumbs up, support my channel, subscribe, click the notification bell so you won't miss any of my future videos. Share this video with your friends, with your coworkers, with your loved ones. Please help me to promote this channel. One more time, my name is Elena Semenek and this is Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life. See you soon, bye!